So then we went to the post office to get Sid, but just as I suspicioned, he warn't there. So the old man, he got a letter out of the office, and we waited a while longer, but Sid didn't come. So the old man said come along, let Sid foot it home or canoe it when he got done fooling around, but we would ride. I couldn't get him to let me stay and wait for Sid, and he said there weren't no use in it, and I must come along and let Aunt Sally see we was all right. When we got home, Aunt Sally was that glad to see me, she laughed and cried both, and hugged me, and give me one of them lickings of hern that don't amount in shucks, and said she'd serve Sid the same when he come. And the place was plumb full of farmers and farmers' wives to dinner, and such another clack a body never heard. Old Mrs. Hotchkiss was the worst. Her tongue was a-going all the time. She says, "Well, Sisters Phelps, I've ransacked that air cabin over, and I believe the nigger was crazy." I says to Sister Damrell, didn't I, Sister Damrell? Says I, "He's crazy," says I. Them's the very words I said. You all heard me. "He's crazy," says I. "Everything shows it," says I. "Look at that air grindstone," says I. "Want to tell me to any creature that's in his right mind is going to scrabble all them crazy things onto a grindstone," says I. "Here's such and such a person's busted his heart, and here's so-and-so pegged along for 37 year, and all that. Natural son of Louis, somebody, in such everlasting rubbage. He's plumb crazy," says I. "It's what I says in the first place. It's what I says in the middle. And it's what I says last and all the time. The nigger's crazy. Crazy as Nebuchadnezzar," says I. "And look at that air ladder made out of rags, Sister Hotchkiss," says old Mrs. Damrell. "What in the name of goodness could ever want of the very words I was a-saying no longer ago than this minute to Sister Utterback, and she'll tell you so herself. She, look at that air rag ladder, she. And," says I, "yes, look at it," says I. "What could he have wanted of it," says I. She, Sister Hotchkiss, she. "But how in the nation they ever get that grindstone in there anyway? And who dug that air hole? And who—" "My very words, Brer Penrod. I was a-saying, pass that air sasser molasses, won't you? I was a-saying to Sister Dunlop, just this minute, how did they get that grindstone in there," says I, "without help, mind you, without help. That's where it is. Don't tell me," says I. "There was help," says I. "And there was a plenty of help, too," says I. "There's been a dozen of help in that nigger, and I lay I'd skin every last nigger on this place, but I'd find out who done it," says I. "And moreover," says I,
"a dozen, says you. 40 couldn't have done everything that's been done. Look at them case knife saws and things. How tedious they've been made. Look at that bed leg sawed off with 'em. A week's work for 6 men. Look at that nigger made out of straw on the bed. And look at—"
"You may well say it, Brer Hightower. It's just as I was a-saying to Brer Phelps, his own self," says he. "What do you think of it, Sister Hotchkiss? See?